Good afternoon. Hundreds of earthquakes recorded in the last 24 hours below Kilauea. Here's a live look at the crater. It is not erupting, but it's showing signs of increased seismic activity as well as deflation over the summit and into the rift zone.
More temporary closures are going into effect at Hawaii Volcanoes National Park, while officials at the USGS say they don't know for sure if there will be an eruption. It is a potential outcome. Alina Lee has the latest.
An increase in earthquake activity has park officials closely monitoring Kilauea.
USGS was reporting about 360 earthquakes just below the summit of Kilauea.
No construction sites at the summit have been impacted, but temporary closures are in place.
Our coastal backcountry sites, Halape, Apua, Keaho, Ka'aha, camping overnight in those areas, temporary suspended. Also, in the remote backcountry of the Southwest Rift Zone, the Pepeiao cabin is closed. Out in the East Rift Zone, the Napau campground is closed. And then an additional closure is the Kau Desert Trail.
How does seismic activity at this time compare to that in the past when there was also a potential for an eruption?
Back in January, we had similar behavior from Kilauea, and it didn't result in an eruption. Instead, the magma below the surface just found other areas to go and never came out and produced an eruption.
According to park officials, it is not possible at this time to know if the increase in earthquake activity will lead to an eruption.
Almost every eruption we have is preceded by shallow, low-level, low-magnitude earthquakes in that area. So it can be a really good signal that an eruption is going to happen. But again, it doesn't always mean an eruption will happen.
As of now, popular areas including Kilauea Visitor Center, Volcano House, Nahuku Lava Tube, Chain of Craters Road, and more remain open. For more information, go to KHON2.com. Alina Lee, KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.
Well, there was mention of that swarm of earthquakes up in January. The difference between this swarm now and January was January's swarms were at the summit into the Southwest Rift Zone. This time around, we are seeing swarms at the summit and also in the Northeast Rift Zone. So again, it does not guarantee an eruption, but sometimes and most often than not, these earthquakes signal magma moving around underneath the subsurface. And the swarms could be gone tomorrow, or it could lead to an eruption. We'll have about 2 to 3 hours of lead time from the USGS should anything happen. Outside of that, we are good to go. We do not have any current alerts for ocean conditions